Pokemon Sun and Moon is on the eve of a release. It releases very shortly, and I wanted to do a very short, to the point video discussing my experiences with new Pokemon releases and what's ruined them for me. So first and foremost, if you're playing through blindly, you need to stay away from spoilers. There's no harm in going on YouTube or looking up some kind of walkthrough of something and finding the answer to your problem, but yeah, you probably don't want to sit there and get surprised by a special gym leader or something, or a certain Pokemon, and then be like, oh man, really wish that wouldn't have been spoiled. A couple other things I'd like to note. As Pokemon has become extremely less challenging, I would strongly advise that everyone who played the demo probably has a lot of stuff to transfer over, and everyone who's played X and Y and Alpha Sapphire, Omega Ruby, and, you know, other games in the past as well, probably have Pokemon transfer over via Pokemon Bank or just trading. I would strongly recommend beating the game without trading any kind at all. Just one time, vanilla experience, and not using legendary Pokemon or any super uber overleveled Pokemon you might get through Sun and Moon. Because just put simply, that's gonna just ruin the challenge. Like, every Pokemon game has an opportunity before the game is over, usually, to catch the legendary Pokemon, and then you can just sweep through the Elite Four with it. It happened with the original generations, it happened with later generations, and it continues to happen, and the challenge slowly, rapidly declines in difficulty. Hence, I'm just strongly suggesting, because generally speaking for me, it just ruins the game if you trade over a really uber powerful Pokemon and just start sweeping through, even if that uber powerful Pokemon is a lower level, even if you're just trading over starters from a different region, because they get boosted experience and it's just gonna make them fly up the charts and become OP. So these are just simple suggestions after you finish the game. I mean, you know, you can do whatever you want, but I'm just warning everyone out there, because a lot of people will probably do this. A lot of kids will be like, oh man, you know, I got a Genesect from way back when, you know, it's level 10, I'm gonna use it. Or, oh man, I got Ash Greninja, you know, I'm gonna use it. And it's like, you know, you're going up against level 10 or 20 by the time you can trade or something, and you're just trashing them, you know? And there's no challenge, there's no fun in it, there's no sport in it. And by the time you're done with it, you're just like, man, that was really boring. Pokemon's getting really boring. Well, it's boring because you're using OP Pokemon, all right? So if you're not planning on doing that, cool. I just, you know, I wanted to throw it out there. So I don't know what gameplay footage I'm gonna use for the background. Obviously, I can't use Sun and Moon until the embargo's up, which is the release date for Pokemon Sun and Moon, so that's not what I'm gonna be using. If you guys enjoyed this video, just quick run through of things, you know, just talking. Make sure to stock up on Pokeballs, as it's a new generation. You're gonna wanna catch a bunch of Pokemon, and then that's about it. I mean, enjoy Pokemon Sun and Moon. I hope it's really awesome. I'm gonna be doing a review of it, and I'll be picking it up tomorrow. Yeah, tomorrow. That's right, guys. I'll be picking it up tomorrow. You guys have yourselves a great day, and as always, good gaming, and God bless. Have fun out there, Pokemon trainers.